Hey, I'm Billy Harris. You're hanging with Harris. We are in Boston at Tico with my very good friend, Michael Schlow. Schlow, how are you?
I'm doing great. I'm hanging with Harris. I mean, how much better could it be?
It can't get much better, and it's long overdue. We've been trying to hang with Harris for a long time. So, we're in Tico.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little different than the usual Schlow, Bostonian, Via Mata, Alta Strada. Different than the Italian.
Well, different than the Italian restaurants, and certainly different than Radius, which is modern American. This is my take on my travels from Spain,
sure.
Mexico, South America, and none of it's authentic, though. It's just how I'm influenced when
sure.
I go to these places.
Sure, sure,
so
sure.
This has been a lot of fun, this restaurant, and the dishes are super easy, they're fast, and there's 53 dishes on the menu. So
just
you get
53,
this.
Which is good.
I was going to go for 54, but I thought it might topple the kitchen down.
It might
down.
Topple the kitchen
yeah.
down.
This is something that's been near and dear to my heart for a long time.
Right.
Just needed the right time and the right place to do it, and the right opportunity presented itself, and so this is the food that we're
so
doing.
So here we are, take over.
Exactly,
doing.
Yes.
All right, chef, so let's kind of get into it. I'm looking at, obviously, some tuna, but what are we going to do?
Well, the first dish is a play on something that is one of my favorite dishes from Spain, and that's called Escalivada salad. Escalivada traditionally has eggplant, peppers, onions in it. It's sort of stewed a little bit, and it's often served with some toasted bread
sure.
and some white anchovies. So what I've done is sort of taken okay. it apart a little bit, and I've got some seared tuna here that's
beautiful.
Been spiced with salt, pepper, a little bit of hot chilies, a little bit of cumin, and a little bit of fennel seed. And so super beautiful sushi-grade tuna.
Could you do it with another fish? Because you also just said, you really would do it with tuna.
I think for this dish, the tuna's probably the best
sure.
fish. But I think, you know, if you had a piece of maybe, if you want to do this as an entree, this is an appetizer.
Right, right.
If you want to do this as an entree, maybe swordfish might be good. Something meaty, for
yeah,
sure.
Something meaty kind of fish.
And so what this is as I said, Escalivada has eggplant and peppers and onions in it. This is a little bit of eggplant puree. So all I
got
did
it.
Was roasted the eggplant, some olive oil, and a little bit of cumin, and I pureed it. I just
okay.
spread it out on the plate like that.
Is that a Schlow technique? That
you know,
it's,
I'm trying
that?
To patent it.
Yeah.
It's patent pending Schlow technique.
It is patent pending.
Actually, the reality is that I think every chef in the world right now is doing the
they
drop
do
and swoosh,
yes.
you know. This is a little bit of salad. It's got piquillo peppers, onions, more eggplant, and a little bit of thyme.
And it smells great already. Now, this is dish out of the 53. What number is this?
This would be number three.
Number three.
Yes.
Okay, just making
and
sure.
And then you just put the tuna right on top. And that's why I say this is so fast and so easy. For a restaurant like this,
right.
where it's a lot of small plates, the food comes out really, really quickly, and everything's meant to share.
So okay. with 53, 54 dishes
yes.
in the restaurant, on a busy night with a couple hundred people there, people were getting 10, 12, 15,
oh, yes.
20 plates per table.
Well, what's
so you guys are crushing it, rocking
well,
it out.
We are rocking it out. This was a little bit of anchovy and smoked paprika vinaigrette that I put around the outside. I'm going to put a little
sure.
bit right on top of the tuna, too.
I love the fact that you talk as fast as me, which is great.
Oh, good. Hopefully,
this will
I cook
be a one-minute
really
interview. Exactly.
I'm going to give you a little taste of this
yeah,
if you
I'm
want.
I'm ready for a little taste.
Just kind of rub that right into the eggplant if you want to get a little bit of the peppers.
A little tuna.
Yeah.
Cuts
and
beautifully.
With the dishes having, you know, with the menu having so many dishes,
mm-hmm.
what we also offer is if you can't decide what you want, tell us what you want to spend. $35, $55,
$85. $4.
I'll get you a taco for
You'll
that.
Get me a taco.
And a draft beer.
But wait, let's talk about that. The
sure.
tuna is like butter. You really get a nice puree of the eggplant, so that's a nice balance. But mm-hmm. I love it with just a little bit of the heat, right?
Yes, a little bit of spice to it.
It's that balance thing, right?
Well, I think everything. I mean, this menu, when I started it, I thought I wrote three words down, and it was acid, salt, and chilies. It's kind of, any chef you talk to,
sure.
that's what they want at the end of the day. We want something that's going to have a little bit of acidity.
The end of the day, they want acid, salt, and chilies.
In those orders, probably,
it's
yes.
a perfect order.
And a cold drink, you know?
And a cold drink.
So that was good. You liked it, though?
Yeah, so that's number three out of 53.
Something
so
like that. And I'm going to give you number seven now because I'm going to put you to work, okay?
I want to go to work.
All right.
What are we
going to
do here, Chef?
We have an induction burner here.
Right, you're
which,
like, oh, look at that, ladies and gentlemen.
It is
cold,
cold to the
and
touch.
And now we will get hot. In It gets hot in literally 2 seconds.
So this is sort of our version of Latin-influenced super mac and cheese. What I want
yes.
you to take a little bit of that extra virgin olive oil.
Very Latin-influenced. Is mac and cheese big in Latin America?
No.
No.
It's big in America.
Just give it a little spritz, a little.
A little
is spritz.
Spritz
it good like Latin American?
I don't, that's perfect.
Too much? Right,
I can't wait
good.
To see this, by the
this
way.
It's going to be fun.
I have been watching your show since,
yes.
well, you were one of the first internet shows ever. When the internet first came
ever.
On, you were.
I actually invented the
internet. Yes.
Exactly. We put a show. What goes with the olive oil, Chef?
You're going to put a little poblano sofrito, which is onions and poblano peppers. Again, starting to give that Latin influence. Go ahead, pop
Boom.
That right there.
Mas?
One more. One
Mas.
More.
All
two
right.
more.
Two more, he says.
There
go.
You go. We want this to taste really full flavored and delicious.
All right, that for good luck.
Okay, and then that's a little bit of diced serrano ham.
Diced
Throw
serrano
a little bit
ham.
And you can pick the bowl up and bring the horse to the water.
I am going to bring the horse to the water.
Versus the
mas?
Water. No, that's good.
Did you like that I threw in the word mas?
Yes, it was beautiful.
You see this? It's not my first rodeo, Chef.
Go ahead, let me see you flip that. Okay, be the sofrito, Billy.
Be the sofrito.
The sofrito.
Be it. Be,
there you
do
go.
The flip. Got it.
Okay, you
now
got
what's
it.
What's happening?
Beautiful. Let's take a couple handfuls of macaroni.
Should I do that?
Are your hands clean?
They're very clean.
Then throw it in there.
Clean as can be. Clean
right.
as can be. A couple handfuls, like a bam.
One more.
And another bam. I should have, that's someone else's trademark.
I think that's somebody else's show.
You're gonna. So I will just go, hey now.
Oh.
That's also someone else's show. I just went with the hey now.
Okay, that's good.
Now
we've got a little sauce. It's a cheesy Mornay bechamel sauce, which is a little bit of milk, a little bit of flour, a little bit of cheese. Pour that right
in. And this is a low-calorie cheese?
There is nothing but vitamin... Stop.
Okay, stop. That was a lot, actually. Okay.
Grab your spoon over there
Do
and start to mix this up.
Do I need a spoon or something? Yes, we got a little heat here.
In that sauce, it is loaded...
a lot of calories.
No, it's loaded with vitamins and minerals.
Vitamins and minerals.
Yes, but see how cheesy and delicious that's starting to look
I do,
already?
And it will also clog my aorta. But
no, 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 you're going to be fine. Yeah. A little salt.
Just let it rest there for a moment.
Yeah, let it bubble away.
A little boom, and over the shoulder.
Of course. We call this Tico Rashi. It's our own spice blend of chilies and cilantro and limes. There's a spice mixture in Japan called Togarashi that's one of my favorite things, and we made a Latin version of it, and we make it here in the restaurant, and it's really, really delicious, and just keep stirring.
Just stir and let it doing its thing.
And what's nice about this macaroni and cheese is different from the macaroni and cheese
already.
That you might make at home or out of a box, as I know you have once or twice eaten out of a box.
Cannot confirm or deny.
This doesn't have to go in the oven. This is something you make on the top of the stove.
Boom.
Now I want you to take some Manchego cheese.
Manchego cheese.
Yep. Throw that right in there. One more.
Boom, for good luck.
One more.
And that for good luck.
Good.
Perfect.
Now toss that together.
I should just be spooning it, or I should be flipping it.
I don't think you should be flipping it.
I shouldn't be flipping that.
No,
that for sure.
I think
that'll be the end of the black suit. It's looking lovely.
You
love it.
I love that you take the show all over also. I have to tell you that I've been watching it and that you go to all these places. You're sort of the everyman.
I am everyman.
That can cook everything.
Not too shabby.
I am very impressed with your skills, and I'm going to take just the slightest taste here.
Okay.
See how you did on your salt and pepper. And
now, I should be doing that as a sous chef right now if I need salt too much.
I think, can I tell you what?
Actually, not too bad.
I think you nailed it on the first try. That is going to be awesome. Let that reduce down a little more. Keep stirring because you don't want the cheese to burn. So you see how nice that tastes right now?
Yeah.
Are you happy with it?
I am actually quite happy with
it. You should be.
And I'm impressed with myself.
It's amazing when you use my ingredients, how good it comes out, right?
Maybe that's the key.
Yeah. You know what? Wouldn't it be great if you could like come home and everything's laid out for you like this and then you cook this way?
Yeah, yeah.
Everybody would cook at home if it was all ready
to
go. And you know what? When I go to my mom's house, sometimes I forget I'm not in the restaurant and I just sort of throw the pans into the corner of the kitchen and wait for her to
clean them up.
Yeah, that doesn't happen.
And you get a slap to the back of the head.
What's wrong with you?
All right, what happens now as it's simmering in the juices?
Okay, so what I would do...
Reduce the heat because we're getting a little stickiness.
Okay, just so you know, macaroni doesn't have any juices.
What? When Harris is cooking it, it's full of juices here today, Schlau. I'll throw that tuna on top just to make it special.
Cheese and tuna,
no,
that's a no-no.
Bad combo.
All right, so you get that going.
All right, you got it
now,
going. I got it.
Plate that right in there.
Just go. With the spoon and go. It's going to fit in here just perfectly.
I hope so.
Perfectly.
Oh, look at that.
It's actually
creamy deliciousness.
It is creamy deliciousness.
And then, you know, one of my favorite parts of mac and cheese or a baked lasagna, anything like that, I love the crispy, crunchy
top.
And unfortunately, when you do it like this, there is no crispy, crunchy top.
Right.
Therefore, we have taken toasted breadcrumbs.
Which you have
And ground them all up ahead of time. And you sprinkle, just cover the top with a beautiful sprinkling of that.
Right, so these are already toasted and fabulous.
Right.
Going onto our super hot.
Keep going. Spread it all the way into the corners.
Corners.
Good.
Corners of love.
You are a messy cook.
I am messy cook.
That's good.
Okay,
that's good.
You said more.
Okay, and a little bit of green onion on top.
Like in the middle, we hit
right,
with that.
All the way around. And you know what? I think you have done it.
So we don't bake that. That's it.
That's it. It's done.
Because the breadcrumbs are already baked.
I think it's good. Let's taste it.
I am going to taste it. We're both going to taste it.
I'm going to take a new fork.
All right, I'm going to do
hot,
the same thing.
Super, you know.
It is going to be super hot. I think Harris did a pretty good job. I'm going over here.
Billy Harris, I will hang with you anytime if that's what you're going to make. That is delicious. Want to wash it down?
I do want to wash it down.
You've had this in the restaurant before. This is a Peron. It's filled with Cava.
Cava.
Spanish sparkling wine.
Okay.
We will toast each other, but unfortunately, there are no glasses.
There are no glasses, so.
We just drink.
That is a work of art, ladies and gentlemen. And you don't drink the whole thing. As you spit on the floor, and now
your
I'm
turn.
Going to...
Try.
Where's the angle coming on this right
you're,
now?
You're good with that. Just don't get it too much on yourself. There you go. And pull the arm out. Oh, or pull it away. Excellent
and
job.
And I tried. Okay. I am... Thank you. Thank you, Bubby. I'm Billy Harris, you're hanging with Harris, Michael Schlau, Tico Restaurant, Via Bada, Alta Strada in Boston. Pay him a visit, we'll see you real soon. Thanks, Chef.